Where did these pictures come from?
These are pictures that the kids took last week. We had a few cameras remaining after we were, had our cameras taken. So they started working as teams and working together. We have an exhibit coming up in August. And the kids are still committed to doing the work. PhotoFest is still committed to doing the work and asking for the public support to help us replace our cameras and get them back to one-to-one. But, you know, the kids have a wonderful spirit and having some fun with this, you know.
Tell us how you had to change your actual lesson plan in order to accommodate this.
Instead of individual cameras and the freedom to work with the cameras as an individual, they're having to work and share the cameras, 2 to 3 kids, 2 cameras, you know.
So. 12 kids per class, 2 sessions a day.
Yes, I'm working with a younger group of kids. This is the 2nd through 4th grade, and we have 5th grade through 8th grade.
Tell us what you need and how people can help.
Well, we're managing some cameras as donations, and people are retiring their point-and-shoot digital cameras, and we're accepting those. But we're really trying to replace the cameras for literacy photography. And we're already a third away of the goal there. We had like $1,000 raised in the first 24 hours through the Facebook activity. Yeah, and you know, so we keep reposting and making some contacts, and people are supporting us in this way. They're going to have a little activity at Antidote on the 22nd. And inviting people to bring cameras and kind of get a coffee and give a product report of where we're at.
Excellent. Yeah. How many years have you been doing this program?
With PhotoFest, I've been working with them about two years. We worked with this group of kids last summer as well. But I've been teaching off and on since 1988 through various organizations throughout the city.
You don't mind?